Hello everybody and welcome to another Ad Hoc Money Match. This afternoon's match is between Neil Turner and Joe Hamm for £300. This is an Ad Hoc Money Match, bringing you Blackball Pool Money Matches. Today's beneficiary is the PDSA and we are live from Rocket Ronnie's in Southampton. Sorry, just a whistle stop because we need to get going. Today's stream sponsor is Coffee One Shirley. and they are hiring. So if you are looking for a new job, they got assistant manager and a part-time barista positions available. So why don't you get in touch with them today? We'll be going over to the lag for break shortly. We were just running late from the last match, so I'm desperately trying to get everything sorted out now. Bear with me. Thank you for joining us, if you just have. Well, that's one thing done. I've got my stream curator, I've got my match curator now. I've just got to sort out the player's scoreboard. And we're just waiting for Neil Turner to arrive to the table to do the lag. So we've got Neil Turner on the red and Joe Hamm on the yellow. And it looks like Neil Turner will take the break. This is frame one, Neil Turner to break. So that was dry, and we have Joe Hamm now at the table. So these two aren't strangers to a stream. Good to see these two back on the table for Rocket Rackers TV. So Joe's on the yellows, and he's covered the pocket down at the bottom left there. Sorry, I'm just spreading the gospel. We've got a little bit of congestion around the bottom right-hand side of this table at the moment. Players will need to work on that. Looks like Neil's going to try and deal with it sooner rather than later. Just doubling that red across. Smart little shot there by Joe. He's just covering that both bottom pockets now. I think Neil was looking for a skill shot there, but he's given a foul away. And two shots to Joe Hamm. I might have to vanish from the microphone at some point soon when my chippies turn up. But I will turn off the microphone so you don't have to hear me go all the time. What's Joe going to do here? He's a couple of yellows just above the black, need developing. At least one of them does, that one. Right, goes into the bottom left pocket now. And he's on the other one. And everything looks set for this frame now. I think he's on this yellow. And he needs to top edge it. Oh, that's unfortunate. The natural angle for the cue ball now is in the middle pocket. He managed to avoid it, and he's got a fortuitous little knock collision there off the red. And he puts the black down to make it 1-0. Now we do have Stuart Berry on the table from 6 p.m. So it might be a bit of a squeeze. Sorry, Stu, if we push your singles match out. But hopefully these lads will blister through some of these frames for you. Didn't expect the last match to take over 4 hours. There's frame two with Joe Hamm to break. Oh, he's put the cue ball down. That's unfortunate. As the yellows followed it. Thank you. So Neil Turner is on these yellows. Neil's a regular down Rocket Ronnie's. He's organising the round robin competition every month. I think that's £20 for players to enter. You know, short races in a group stage. And then there's a cup and a plate. Thank you for tuning in, those that have. Hope you're enjoying your bank holiday Monday afternoon. Don't forget to give us a like and subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell. And if you want to find out information on when new competitions open for entry, find us on Facebook. That's Rocket Rackers TV. That's the best way to get in touch. Also, if you would like to have a money match streamed, it's a great way for your backers to access the action if they can't make it to the venue, especially if you have backers for the big ones. And it also makes an invaluable educational tool if you're looking to improve, then having the stream recorded for posterity for you to look over and some constructive criticism from the commentary to let you know when you could have done something different or if a pattern emerges that's holding you back. Very valuable. So I know Neil Turner's not a stranger to a money match, but I don't know how often Joe Hamm has played for money. It'd be interesting to see how he does today. So if he takes this yellow into the middle, he can take the one to the right of the black. And then he just wants a good enough angle. He's got the big pocket with the red sat over the middle for when he gets on that yellow. He's not on the yellow. He's going to have to kick it. Kick it off the bottom right cushion. Well, he made decent contact with it. Is Joe going to find a shot here, or is he just going to go for a snooker? I'm going to take this red into the top left. We can just go for the snooker here. That's all right. Well, chippy chips have arrived. Let's dart across and get them in a moment. Thank you. I'll try and commentate on this match and eat at the same time, but I don't want to be rude. I'll scoff during the interval. How's that? Let them cool down a little bit first as well. A little bit unfortunate there for Joe. He's going to have to try a plant now. He's going to go for a snooker. That's a nice little snooker there. Neil was unable to escape that one. He didn't want that to drop. He's not giving himself the position. Well, he recovered and he snookered nil. Neil's recovered from that, but Joe's on a shot now. Should be able to close out the frame from here. It's not great positioning though. Looks like he's going to need to double it. Fantastic shot by Neil. And he slammed that black down to make it 1-1. So it's frame 3-0, Turner to break. Well, I snuck a few chippies in then, yum yum yum. So Neil's got a yellow down. And he's on a yellow. Maybe it's the only thing he's on. Snuck a red in. She doesn't really have a problem ball here now.
I'm assuming he would prefer to get on this red on the left bottom rail with this shot. Oh no, that red below the black might be covered. Not straightforward. Good pot there with the double, but it's not left him in an ideal position. It's always the danger. And he's put the black in the middle of the bottom cushion. He's going to try and cut this across. He didn't quite have the room. So Joe Hamm is back on the table. So with that shot, it looks like Neil's all set for this frame now. I believe he can get through to that red. He can always come off the cushion a little bit if he needs to. And I believe the black passes into the middle left. It definitely goes in the middle right. But I believe it'll be the middle left he wants to take it into. And he does so to make it 2-1. So Neil's definitely arrived today. Joe Hamm's here. They've both got frames on the board. And Neil's in good potting form. Frame 4, Joe Hamm to break. He's got two reds down. And a good shot on this yellow here. Bit of an awkward red into the bottom right if he really wanted it. If he goes for that yellow though, he needs to develop this chain of yellows below the black. Where's this black going? Well, he's put the cue ball in a good place there. It doesn't look like Neil has a shot I mean, you might be able to nip this top of the two reds at the bottom of the table into the bottom right pocket. Or the highest of the reds into the bottom right pocket. Well, he's played that nicely. He got the cannon. I think this shot's quite straight. He's going to have to try and find a way to get position. Still got some traffic from these yellows. That's a wonderful shot there. Can he take this red up to the top left? Or is he going to take the bottom right first? I'm not sure that top red passes the black into the middle. Just to let all of our Pompey fans know, Sean Raggett's scored before the half to make it 1-0. Pompey, were he? Not that it's consequential at this point in the season. We need all the teams above us to completely bottle it for every single match they have left for us to scrape into the playoffs. That was an excellent shot there by Neil. And is he on this black? Yeah, it's a little tight there, but he's made it 3-1. And that was a dish. So he composed himself for 4 minutes around that table. And Joe Hamm didn't get a shot other than the break. And a couple of reds off it. And this is Neil Turner breaking frame 5. Unfortunately, it's dry. So all these yellows are in quite a good position here. Nice little plant, but he's run out of position. Still got to mind what you're doing with the cue ball. So these two reds by the middle right pocket need some work. I mean, they might plant up to the top right pocket. Need to go under them. Well, at least they're separated and developed now. Joe's got a yellow into the middle left, I believe. Always difficult, those ones. Well, double time to those chips, so they're all gone now. Hopefully, that means I can just focus on the commentary instead of stuffing me gullet. We got any fans of Joe or Neil watching at the moment? Pop a message in the chat. I know that YouTube plays up a little bit on mobile devices. Makes it hard to message on the live chat. This could be a good chance here for Joe now. Hello, Simon Ayers. How you doing, my friend? Hope you enjoyed your time up at the GB9. I heard that Adam did quite well. Won himself a few matches. Well, this is looking promising. Joe's just got to hold the white. And he's used the red to do so. Perfect. And a wonderful black there to make it 3-2. So 5 frames in half an hour. These two are cracking on with it. This is frame 6. Joe Hamm to break. And he's got a yellow down. I assume Simon Ayers will be back in the hall next Saturday to be running the Q Sports Academy. After his little jaunt up the country. So Joe's got a couple of yellows straddling the black to deal with. I'm not sure if he could do so now and guarantee being on a yellow. Oh, that's wonderful. He's pipped one out there. It's just going to be difficult to get on that last yellow, though. Yeah, if he can take this top yellow now. Yeah, it is a bit of a long day, Simon. I've just had to scoff myself some chips to keep myself going. Can't be combating low sugar levels whilst trying to give all you guys engaging commentary on the action. But it's all worth it. I don't think my bum could take more than two matches, though, especially these race to 15s. After the last big money match day, where we had race to 21. Come back from that after sitting on these stools. It was felt like I'd been on the Stairmaster for a couple of hours. And walking up the stairs, I had dead legs. It was quite difficult. I have to remember to stand up a few times throughout the day. Maybe in the future, if I get enough subscribers and enough revenue, I could buy myself a vat of gel that I could suspend myself in whilst doing the commentary. Might be a bit messy, but it will be easy on the joints. Well, unless Joe's hoping for a deflection off the red to the left of that yellow above the black to send it in the middle. I'm not sure how he's going to get on it. He might just want to put this yellow over a pocket. I'm not sure about getting a throne, Simon Ayers. Have you seen those things? They're made of hardwood and they rarely have a cushion on them. They look quite intimidating. The one in Game of Thrones was made of swords, for goodness sake. Imagine sitting on that all day. End up with throne bum. An ailment exclusively suffered by kings and queens. At least I could guess I could have the peasants come and kiss my ring. Maybe an inflatable throne would be a good idea. That way I could collapse it and pop it in the storage cupboard afterwards. Space saving. Although I might get a little high inflating it. Oxygen deprivation. So Neil's got to develop these two reds just below the black as well. He could probably pop the bottom one. Well, he can pop both of them if he's got the right angle. Oh, there you go. He had a shot on there. Easy peasy. But he does need to nudge the black at some point. He might be better off taking the top left red here. So he could have given himself a bit of a better angle for that red he's just potted to come into the black and the yellow. Instead, I think he's hoping he can get. He's hoping the angle exists. I'm not sure it does. Well, he flicked it in there, but he was trying to force his way onto that yellow and black. And he's not made it. Well, the angle existed and he's taken it and he's made it 4-2. Just goes to show you that the best angle is the one you're able to get walking around the table. It's a bit difficult to see what's going on from the screen. So it's frame 7, Neil Turner to break. And the cue ball's jumped down the hole. And it's the only thing that did. I might go for reds. I think Joe's gonna use a red to put a yellow down here though. He's got a free shot. What's he gonna do with it? He's used his free shot just to push a yellow away from the pocket and take the middle pocket. That's a smart move. And now he's got a pot of red to make sure that it was worthwhile. It's a busy day here in Rocket Ronnie's. And Joe Hamm is Reds. And he kicks that one in. It's good to see Ben Lindsay and Darren Daniels sharing a pint after their morning match. That went all the way to the wire. And a very scrappy last frame as well. Very tactical. Neither player wanted to give it up. Joe's done quite well here. He's in a good position in this frame. Leave the middle red to last? I think so, because otherwise the cue ball will run down the table. I don't think he really wants to run down the table and then try and come back up. So he'll take this top red into the top right. And that's perfect. All he's got to do now is hold the cue ball. Might want to put just a tiny bit of bottom on this. And so from Neil's foul break, Joe Hamm gets a reverse dish and makes it 4-3. And does so in only 3 minutes and 30 seconds. That was a good effort there by Joe. So this is frame 8, Joe Hamm to break. He's got his patented skew-if rack. But nothing's down. We've got lots of bunching on the left-hand side of this table. Neil's taking these yellows. And he's done well there to shift that red out of the way. Just this middle of the three on the left of these yellows, a bit difficult. But you could develop that now with this shot. Or not, unfortunately. Well, he's run out of a shot now, so development of that yellow is probably the best thing to do. So Joe's got a red of his own that he needs to develop there. It was just stuck on that yellow. He'll just send a yellow across the table, covering a pocket. Sensibly done. I mean, Joe could try and skill it in. He takes this red to the middle right pocket. He would have a red to the bottom left after that. Nope. But he could double this red on the bottom right cushion now up to the middle left. Ah, that's unfortunate. It's pushed the red over onto the cushion. Neil just taking a touch to bring his yellow off the cushion. Everything goes now. And Joe is under the red that is hampered and covered. We'll try and take that up to the top right. It's a good shot. And now he's got an angle on this. I think to try and disturb that red on the bottom left cushion, just below the middle pocket. It's got a small angle. Well, he had a go. He needs to get this cue ball down the table now. Big screw. No. He's just going to play that red down the cushion. That's a good shot. That's a very good shot. And now he's set for the frame. He's plumb on this black. So wants to stun it into the top right pocket. And he does to make it 4-4. So nothing to separate these two so far. Neil got himself a 2-frame lead, but that's all but been erased at this point. And our next scheduled stream is Saturday, the 23rd of April at 11 a.m. Join in for that one. It's Luke Cross versus Rich Chalk for £300 and a race to 15. Just waiting for Darren to grab his e-scooter out of the cupboard, which he has done. This is Neil Turner breaking frame 9. And everything stayed up. That yellow wanted to drop, but it hasn't. And it's not a simple shot here for Joe. He could try taking the yellow on the left bottom cushion down. And at least then he'd have the one over the middle. But he's going to go and try and put this yellow into the bottom right. It's a wonderful shot there. What a shot. Joe Hamm has definitely turned up today. So he's just got this one problem yellow, which is on the right cushion. He's going to need to deal with that sooner rather than later. Can he get to that top yellow? He's going to start running out of position soon. Yeah, you can get to that top yellow. Does he roll far enough past the reds? No, we'll have to take the one into the middle. That's okay, as long as he leaves himself an angle on this outer yellow to interfere with the red and try and push that yellow out. He's going to need to put some bit of power into this, and a bit of right hand side, or left hand side rather. Well, he's on it. It'll be very difficult to cut that in. I'm not sure the double's available. It might be. Looks like he's going to cut this down. It was the finest of angles. It was really difficult to put power into that. And now it's returned to the table. Well, Neil's covered the pocket there. Giving Joe some trouble. He's going to have to just... Well, it's always going to be difficult to get a skill shot from that. Maybe Joe's deliberately taken the foul. I mean, I just couldn't see a universe in which that skill shot would be pulled off. But Neil's not taking the advantage of the free shot there. He's just cracked on with the frame. Could have used his free shot to put Joe's yellow on a cushion. But he's obviously feeling confident enough to march forward. Looking good for this one. Maybe would have hoped to travel a few inches further back than that. Oh, he's got a snooker. Joe's made contact. Where's the cue ball? Wow, look at that. think Neil's concerned about that. It's quite close to that knuckle. You couldn't have played that if you wanted to. Ah, he's put the red in. Where is he on this black? Oh, I think it's covered. And he's very close to this black as well. Not sure what he can do here. Well, the yellow's not in the best place for Joe here. And he knows that the black is in the middle of the table for Neil. Can find a pocket for that quite easily. He's gone for the bottom left, and it's bounced in the pocket. Well, the trajectory for the cue ball off this black, if Neil goes to the bottom right, could take it into the middle. And that's what he was afraid of. You could see the cue ball action there. This is a difficult black. It's not an easy cut to the middle. And he's left it for Neil. And Neil makes it 5-4. Third away through this match now. This is frame 10. This is Joe Hamm to break. Oh, look at that. It was a wonderful break. And he's on a red to the middle. Yeah, two reds and a yellow go down there. Now, can he take the left of these two reds? He might have to take the right of the two. And then take that red into the middle. Thank you. wonder if he's looking at the plant for the two yellows on the left hand side there. Well, if he was, he wasn't able to take it that way in the end. Joe Hamm is in a good position now for these. Oh, mind you, one of his reds is covering. Might find it difficult to get up onto that top red. Unless he gets a good bit of power off this one. Puts a bit of left hand side on it. Did he touch that black first? I'll have a look at that. He must have. Either way, it wasn't called. Something to look back on. Yeah, it really does look like he touched that black first. There's no other way. But neither player called it. Maybe neither player saw it. And the frame's progressed too far now. I guess they'll have to have a fight about it tomorrow. Fisticuffs at dawn. And Joe takes the frame. Perhaps controversially. But it's 5-5. I'm not sure if any breaks have been discussed. But these two are cracking on. And just an update in the big football match of the day. Pompey are still winning 1-0 against Morecambe. Up the Blues. Play up, Pompey. Let me know in the chat if you disagree with that sentiment. This is frame 11. Neil Turner to break. That's a mighty spread, but it looks dry again. Mm. Joe's on the reds. And he just takes an early snooker. And that red is tied up and he didn't get a snooker. And now Neil's been able to cover a pocket. I don't think it's one Joe will need, but gives Neil an easy plant. It doesn't look like Joe's got a shot here. He might have one to the middle. Top red. So Neil's got to liberate the yellow from the black. And Joe's got a red to liberate. There's a good shot there by Joe. If he's able to get enough power inside on this, he might be able to hit that black into the red. Push the red up towards the middle pocket. Not quite. He's liberated the yellow, unfortunately. Manil will still have to develop the black. I think Joe's run out of shot here. He's going to try and take this middle red into the top left pocket. And he does so. That's a good shot. Just got to think about what he's going to do with that last red, though. I don't think there's anything he can do with it. He might be able to double it. He'd have to do really well to get to the angle for that, though. Oh, that's unlucky. Mind you, he's full balled, so you can kick that up to the middle pocket and then just hope that Neil doesn't clear up, I guess. He's looking at maybe trying to play it with some side off the top cushion and down. At least he'd be able to kick it towards the corner pocket. Bit riskier, but the payoff would be greater. There's very little to be gained by not being adventurous there. Because that red's still unpottable. But he has stopped Neil from getting to the top yellow. Maybe Neil doesn't have a pot here. He might have to play a free ball plant. Oh, he's managed to play that perfectly. It's hard to stop a pool player who's got a few tricks up his sleeve. Neil should be able to run out this frame now. Difficult to get good position from this shot. He can't dig down into the ball. He's going to have to go up and down, or down and up. Now he's got behind the yellow, but the angle's going to take the cue ball away. He's going to have to go bottom cushion and then bottom left cushion, come back up and try and get behind the black. Unless he wants to try and double it. Joe's red is against the cushion, though. So Neil's just gone for the snooker. And Joe's going to have to kick this. But he's not going to get any advantage from it. Unless he can get a snooker here. Oh, look at that. What a perfect recovery. That is totaled, I believe. Looks like it. As far as I'm concerned, you don't have to apologise for getting that result. Oh, and he's put the red down. Now he's on this black. It's a difficult cut, but it is potable. Oh, he's just covered the pocket there. I think Neil will try his own double. Well, there should be frame for Joe now. Six-five to Joe Hamm, and for the first time in this match, he takes the lead. So this is frame 12, and Joe Hamm to break. Alright, he's got a yellow down, red over the pocket, red down. So these yellows look quite good, really. That is probably the difficult one, but if he can pop that into the left middle. Just trying to figure out his way around it. I think if he puts this one into the left middle now and then comes down for the bottom. Oh, and he's just missed it. At least that yellow now goes into the right middle too. Neil doesn't have a straightforward shot on here either. That's the way she blows. He's played a good shot there. He's stopped Joe from having a straightforward shot himself. I think we're going to try and just double this one. This top yellow towards the middle right pocket. I'll try and cut it in the middle. He doesn't want to tie it up, and that's what he's done. Let's put it over on that left bottom cushion. Made life a little bit harder for himself. Neil could pot all these now. Just checking if the middle of these reds passes into the middle right pocket. If it does, then he'll probably take this left one up into the top left first. I'm not sure that red does pass though, you need to screw back. Well, he could just take the one into the middle now. And then he can take the middle red into the left middle. Just got to make sure he gets down the table on the left hand side so he can take the black into the middle right. This looks good for it now. Oh, that was unfortunate. I mean, well, you can take this into the bottom left now. It does pass the yellow. And it's 6-6. Another little reminder, our next stream is on Saturday at 11 a.m. That's Luke Cross versus Rich Chalk in a race to 15 for a £300 prize pot. I think that'll be Luke's first money match live on the stream with us. Rich has done a couple of them now. And that stream is sponsored by Coffee One, Shirley, who are now hiring. So don't forget to hit that notification bell so you don't miss it.
This is frame 13. Neil Turner to break. Yellow down. Oh, would you believe it? Morecambe have equalised in the 93rd minute. Absolute scoundrels. Well, that finishes off any hope for the playoffs. But we'll go again next year. So this table is still open. Joe's not really on an easy shot here. Maybe he could cut this yellow into the top left. He just wanted to try and take a shot away from Neil. And the table stays open. Well, that might tempt Joe onto the reds here, but he does have a yellow into the middle, I believe. And the table remains open. And Neil takes the yellows. So Neil finishes that visit, just separating a couple of the yellows there. Joe's got the red by the black that needs developing. That's a good shot. Can he focus on something else? Or does he have to deal with that now? It's not always beneficial to leave that. I mean, he could use that shot to get the cue ball down the table. Oh, he's not really got himself on something there.
He was quite straight on that one, but it was right in the pocket. He could have topped it rather than screwed it. We've got a lot more travel out of the cue ball. Well, he's looking to try and send the cue ball off the top of this red and onto the red over the pocket. Oh, he's managed to cut it in. And he's pushed that yellow out of the way. But he's still not dealt with the red by the black yet. He's covered the pocket. That will do. That was the best outcome, really, I think. Didn't really have the legs to keep attacking this frame. Not without developing that red by the black. And now he's got two reds that cover the yellow. The yellow Neil's probably going to take now into the middle. It's the only shot he has, and it's the best one to take, really, because it is covered into these two bottom pockets. But he's just flicked that there. And he's put it safe. If I was Joe, I would double this red just above the black now. Just put it over the middle. If it pots, then happy days. If not, then it's in the right place. Oh, and it stayed out. Joe doesn't need that pocket, but it has made a yellow all the easier for Neil. Neil's still got a yellow pretty much on the cushion, though. Above this left middle. Oh, that's jumped out the pocket there. A little bit of understandable frustration by Joe. Can he send this one across and get the pot? No. Oh, Joe definitely wants to rescue this red. Is it going in? Not nearly. Well, so long as... I don't know what it's... It's going to have to double this yellow. I think that red's a bit too far out for the big pocket. You could try it. It might push the red towards a cushion. Or at least cover the pocket. I don't think he's done enough to cover it, though. Joe just seems to be getting a little bit wound up. He's at a 6-6. He's doing all right. And the black's still on the cushion. Neil snookered himself. So would you make your first... make his first port call to clear that pocket. Just to make sure. But then that would leave Neil on the black. He's gonna, double the... Just bring it out into the open. That does make this a bit more dangerous now. Yep, that'll work out nicely. Oh, where's the yellow gone? He's covered himself. Should have dealt with that yellow first. Oh, he's double kissed it. Just a failure of shot selection, I would believe that. Well, Joe will get to finish out this frame. And he makes it 7-6. I think they're going to have a little break. Do stick with us though. Today's cause is PDSA, saving pets and changing lives. If you're looking for a cause to support, then PDSA's as good a choice as any. Today's stream sponsor is Coffee One Shirley. They are hiring an assistant manager and a part-time barista, so apply within. Today's venue, as always, is Rocket Ronnie's in Southampton. A fine pool hall. You are watching Rocket Rackers TV. Please like and subscribe for more live pool streams. You can also find us on Facebook. That's the best way to get in touch if you would like your money match streamed. You're watching Neil Turner versus Joe Hamm for £300 in a race to 15.
We're about halfway through this match now. Nearly. As we saw earlier, Ben Lindsay defeated by Darren Daniels, 15 frames to 14 in our morning money match. And we've got a couple more money matches coming up. Our next stream is Luke Cross versus Rich Chalk. And it's a race to 15 on Saturday, the 23rd of April at 11 a.m. If you're not too fed up with listening to my voice or watching live Blackball Pool, then tune in for that one. Something to watch before the footy. That's frame 14. Joe Hamm to break. Yellow down, red down. Cue ball snugly up against the red there. He's taken some options away. He's 7-6 ahead, but maybe he's struggled to get the rum of a couple of shots. A good shot on the yellow. Five more to go. So none of these are problematic per se, but he's struggling with position at the moment, having to recover from the position of that break. It's a good shot. You can just drop this one into the middle left. Can drop the one in on the left rail. He wants a little bit of screw back if he can. He can't put too much power into this because it will bounce out the pocket, as they always do those shots. And we got timber falling all over. If you or someone you know is looking to get on the stream, then the best way to do that is to find me on Facebook. That's Rocket Rackers TV on Facebook. You can send the page a message. Or you can find me, Lee Ingram. My Facebook profile is, the picture is the same as the one that flashes up in the top left corner in the commentator's box. We support multiple commentators as well, up to four technically. Four might be too many, I reckon, but If you want your friends to commentate, then that can be accommodated. O'Neill's looking good for these Reds. We need to take the left one first. He's going for the right one. No, I think he just wants to drop down off this one now. Take the black into the bottom right. A little bit hampered by the cushion there, but he's nailed it to make it 7-0. And that was a dish. So, 3 dishes in this match so far. 2 for Neil, 1 for Joe. Frame 15, Neil Turner to break. Right, hit that one. He slammed his foot at the same time. I wonder if that's part of the technique. Well, you got 2 yellows and a red down. You could probably pick the yellow off the top of this black now if you wanted into the middle. Oh, you might fancy the reds. Wary of ABS or achy bum syndrome. I'm going to have a little stand. Neil's taking the yellows. Got to tense the glutes. He took these yellows, but I wondered what his strategy for freeing up the 2 with the black. I'm not sure it was there. Maybe hoping that Joe would deal with it for him, and he would get another visit to the table. Likewise, I think Joe's running out of opportunities here to do the same. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell. It's the first step in your journey to joining the Rocket Rackers TV community. So a snooker there for
Joe, and he's failed to escape it. So that's two shots to Neil Turner. And at least that top yellow is possible now. And that black's still tied up. And he's not on a simple shot here. And he can put the top left yellow. But he's going to be fighting for positioning all the way around. He's got it down. How's he going to liberate this black? I don't think he is. Take something special from here. Well, at least he can hit it. Oh, and he's managed to get the pot. What a wonderful shot. Oh, Neil Turner's got a couple of tricks up his sleeve. Managed to use a red to give him the angle he needed. And he's gone 8-7 into the lead. This is frame 16, Joe Hamm to break. It looks like we will be holding this table a bit later than the next booking would appreciate. Again, sorry about that, Stuart Berry. Frames take about 7 or 8 minutes on average, I would say. Race to 15. That's 29 frames. That's what we had in the last stream. When there's money on it, people generally try to make it go all the way. Well, I guess he can put this red in the middle up to the top left. And he's going to be looking at a double for the last red. So James got a yellow or two, hampered by that red. So I need to find a way to develop them. This could be a good opportunity if this yellow passes. Yeah, spread them all away nicely. This frame is on for Joe Hamm now. Most difficult yellow has to be the one on the cushion. But he's shown he can put those down. He's gone a little far there. I'd probably suggest taking the one on the rightmost yellow down into the bottom right pocket. Lots of left hand side. You can try and come and get behind the one on the left rail. He would have then covered the pocket potentially. Well, he's lucky that Neil has snookered himself. There's always the possibility your opponent will play a bad positional shot. Kick the yellow in. So Joker just put the black in a more favourable position if that's what he wants to do. He's just going to try and put this red in the middle of the cushion. He's got to be careful here. Let's put it over the pocket. He covered himself in that pocket. So he's going to need to take this yellow into the middle. And now he's gone quite far with that. That would do. I'll play this gently. Well, this cue ball stuck on the cushion, but Neil should be able to put it in. That should be 9-7. And it is. Today's stream sponsor is Coffee One Shirley. Nestled within the eclectic mix of Shirley High Street, Coffee One Shirley is a light and airy place where a warm welcome awaits you. Popular with locals, their large open area is ideal for families and meeting up with friends. Or head for one of the cozy corners where you can get away from it all and relax for a while with a coffee and a treat. Coffee One Shirley are currently hiring. They are hiring a assistant manager full-time and a part-time barista, 20 hours. So if you know someone looking for a new job, why not direct them down to Coffee One Shirley.
This is frame 17. Neil Turner to break. Well, the balls went everywhere other than in a pocket. Joe takes yellows. I think he's run out of position here. Unless he can cut this top yellow in. Looks unlikely. Looks can be deceiving. It's going to be tough to hold for this yellow into the middle now. Neil's just got the red on the rail at the top. Other than that, everything's quite straightforward. I'll take this red into the middle now. Now he's on that rail red. Probably going to get a better opportunity for it than this. And he's looking good to finish this flame. Wow, there's an opportunity here for Joe. Top left into the left, top yellow into the left middle. Last yellow into the bottom left. Screw up the black. Bish bash bosh into the right middle. And it's 9-8. So it's frame 18, Joe Hamm to break. A little hop from the cue ball, but it stays on. And we have a yellow down. And he's on a yellow. The middle's got a red covering the yellow, though. He's also on reds. The reds do look quite good. Well, both do. I think I might be tempted to go for the reds. That's exactly what Joe does. And he's put the cue ball down. That's unfortunate. So it's still an open table. So Neil just ties up a yellow. He's obviously thinking about taking the reds. He's not giving himself the easiest shot on a red, but this will be all right. And just push a yellow onto a red. So you could probably go right middle, left middle, right bottom, and then left bottom for the black. In an ideal world, I guess, in my head. Oh, you can take the right bottom now, and then left middle. And then bottom right for the black. And Neil makes it 10-8. With a dish. That's a nice quick frame there. We are live at Rocket Ronnie's in Southampton with over 30 tables of various discipline, including English Supreme Winner pool tables, blackball tables, snooker tables, Chinese and American pool tables. We've got dartboard area and live BT Sports on 6 50-inch TVs plus a 10-foot projector screen. They're open 10 till midnight Monday to Saturday and 10 till 10 on Sunday. No memberships required, so just pop on down to pay and play. They also have a junior Q Sports Academy for juniors aged 10 to 18. It's Neil Turner breaking frame 19. He's got a yellow down. He's got a red into the right middle. The reds look quite good here. Has to be said, I'd prefer the red.
Oh, he's gone for yellows. An interesting little plant there. I guess all the yellows are on. Joe Hamm to the table. He's got a red by the black. You might be able to disturb them now. The red into the middle. But he's looking at these top two reds. Just going to take the one closest to the cushion. He's running out of opportunities to deal with the red by the black. He's not going to be able to do it with this shot because he can't put power through these shots. He will bounce out of the pocket. Yep. Every time you put power in that shot, it will bounce out of the pocket. Joe should know that by now. I think all pool players who've been playing for a couple of years should definitely know that. That is not a power shot. That is a drop it in gently shot. And Neil can take on this yellow on the top cushion. And just cut it across to the top left pocket. And it will rattle in the jaws. But it's over the pocket. And Joe needs to find a bit of luck here now. Because he's going to struggle to develop that red. He's left it till last. Well, this might be all right. He's done okay. It's a difficult shot. Well, this is Neil's fame to finish up now. Neil could probably play the simple plant into the top left. He really just needs to drop this one in, and the cue ball will come out far enough for the left, the yellow into the left middle. Oh, he sliced it. And he's put the cue ball down. That really was an unforced error there. So Neil has the old school stance. He doesn't get right down on the shot. And Joe's cleverly just put the black right in the middle of the table. Just needs to make sure he gets good position on this shot now. Down into the bottom left it is. And it's 10-9. So this is frame 20, Joe Hamm to break. Red down. Bit of a cluster in the middle of the table. So Joe's taken the yellows. Neil's now at the table. He's definitely got at least one red he needs to develop. He's got a yellow covering a red into the middle. He's got a little work to do. Neil just plays that red out to the top left pocket. He's just got one red to develop now.
Thank you.
St. Joe's got a couple of yellows tied up on that red that need developing. Wondering how he's going to deal with these two yellows, though. He's not been finding ways to deal with his problem balls early, but that certainly dealt with it. Both of them go now, and he can take one of them he freed into the left middle. A bit sloppy in the end. So you have to try and double this one. That looks good. And he's on the yellow. That was a good recovery shot. He's got a little bit of an angle here. He needs to make the most of it. No, just straight through. And take the black into the left middle. And he makes it 10-all. So this match not going anywhere. Frame 21, we're in the final third of this match. That was Neil Turner breaking. He's played to break off the bottom cushion there. So maybe for something a bit different. And Joe will pick up the table off a dry break. So Joe just developed a couple of yellows there. on his last shot. Turners on these reds. Let's have a look. It's not really got anything that's problematic. Everything goes. Well, whether he meant to cover the pocket or not, he has. Good shot there by Joe. He's recovered a problematic yellow. Not sure if he might try and kick this one in. Yeah, there he is. No, yeah, no, yeah. Oh, he's just grazed it. I think I'd take the bottom red here. And he's come up for the top red. And now you want to try and get... a good position for the bottom red after this, perhaps. Be that red, he's on it. It'll have to be the higher red up to the top right pocket. And it's good. Not the perfect positioning, but he does have a shot on this. He might have to double it. Looks like he's going to try and just cut this in. And he has. And he's sneaking himself on the black, unfortunately.
It's good recovery. But I think Joe has a shot on this right hand yellow down to the bottom right pocket. In the pocket. It's over the pocket. It's in the jaws. Joe needs to clear up from here. And that's 11-10. It's a nil turn up. Frame 22, Joe Hamm to break. He's got a red down. And he's on a red into the middle. We can probably plant a red down into the bottom right. Plant is what he did. A very tidy shot there by Joe, and I assume that bottom left red goes. He just got to make sure he gets good positioning on it. And that black goes into four of six pockets. Might try and use the yellow to stop here. Well, I think that's this visit over. It'll be difficult to pot this red. Now the black is tied up.
Trying to use... Oh, he's covered the pocket. Has snookered Joe here. It's not going to be straightforward to get out of this one. He's going to go up and down. It should be okay. Oh, and he just missed it. I wonder if you played it with a little bit less pace. Neil needs that pocket cleared. And he's done so, and he's put the cue ball down. Joe, I was going to get both of these yellows out of the way with one go. Try and double it from here. Ah, it's a wonderful double to take the frame. 11-0. This is frame 23, Neil Turner to break. Let's try again. We've got the big pocket there for Joe if he wanted to take that red into the middle. Open table. There's still that big pocket available. It's a bit tight still, but it's there. Who's going to blink first? Joe uses the big pocket, take the yellows. Probably wants to pick off this bottom yellow into the middle now. Just make sure that the yellow above it passes into the bottom left pocket if he needs it to. Quite the way off there. Red's out on top of the black, passes into the middle left pocket. It's probably worth developing a bit though. Neil's also got a red on this top left cushion to deal with, as well as a red on the bottom right cushion. That's a good shot there by Neil. Oh, how's he going to get position for the next shot? To double this now. So he's got to develop this yellow. It's just touching the red. Does need to be developed there. That was a good shot there by Joe. He's managed to find a snooker and develop that yellow. And he's left his yellows all pottable. He's left Neil the task of recovering. I'm not sure if he's a full bald either. I think he can just skim this red. Ah, he can pot it. So not quite good enough there. Yeah, I think Neil put a little bit of swerve on that just to make up. So we got Joe back at the table here. He's got quite an easy snooker, I guess, available to him. Neil's not played that with enough pace and has pushed the red onto the cushion. It gives Joe a little bit of breathing space. But he's left the cue ball in at an angle where Neil might fancy doubling this. He's just looking to see if that's snookered and how severely snookered it is. That's a good shot by Joe. He's got under this yellow on the top left cushion. Yeah, I'm not sure if he's got the clearance past the black for this yellow to the middle. He's left himself quite hampered on this red now. It's going to be a very difficult shot. So you fancy Neil to be able to clear this one up? Come too far on that. We should be able to double it though. We'll just cut it straight into the middle. And it makes it 12-11. That was a long old frame, 15 minutes. Joe Hamm to break, and the cue ball's gone down. So Neil takes the reds. Neil's just been looking at these reds covered by the yellow down there in the bottom left pocket. He's going to have to play a plant now. He's got a good angle on this cut to bring the cue ball over to the left-hand side of the table. As long as he can avoid the yellow. And he just covers the pocket. Oh, that's a good shot there by Neil. Trevor's very well and truly snookered. He's going to need maybe three cushions at least. One, two, three, four. Good recovery. So Joe tried to recover some of those yellows there. And so Neil is covering the bottom right pocket with his reds. So he's going to try and glance off this yellow. He's got a nice snooker there. Good recovery. Now just needs to get a good position on the black now. He can't take it into the bottom left pocket, so it's going to have to be either the middles or the bottom right. Exactly where I didn't want to be. I just want to put the black on the cushion. That was a very good double plant there by Joe Hamm. Set himself up perfectly for this. A nice little positional shot there to get behind the black. And he makes it 12 all.
So we're at frame 25. Neil Turner to break. A very soft one there, ensuring a scrappy frame. Couple of straightforward reds for Joe to take here if he wants them. He's gone for the yellows. Had to plug a new battery into the camera. It's been a long day for that camera. It's been streaming to the computer since 10:30. It's 6:30 now. So it's a solid 8 hours of graft for the S7 Edge. That is bringing you these pictures. Fortunately, I brought a spare battery. The camera got down to 58%. And of course with these things, as they get hot, the battery starts to bleed energy. Hopefully that will sustain us for these 5 more frames. Well, I don't know what Joe's going to do to get these 2 yellows separated from the pack. Just wants to nudge this yellow into the cushion and roll the cue ball at the table. Yeah, he didn't want to pot it. Oh, he's going to pot the cue ball. Now just use his free shot to free up his reds. He's managed to leave Joe's yellows tied up. Be able to use the bottom yellow to guide the top yellow towards the pocket here. Even if he pots that yellow though, this black doesn't go. Best he could do is try and leave it over the pocket. I
think that's what Neil wanted to do there. All these reds do go now for Neil. Might want to consider these top two reds now. Leave himself the bottom red as the last red. Gives himself the best chance to get on the black at the end. I'm sure you can find good position on this black though now. And he makes it 13-12. So Neil Turner's one frame off the hill now. This is frame 26, Joe Hamm to break. That was a good break, got a red down, two reds down. Doesn't seem to be a straightforward shot available though. Maybe he could cut one of the red or yellow at the top up. In. Yellow's for Joe. Joe's going to have a tricky plant down at the bottom of this table, I think. Unless he can get the cue ball right down. Let's have a straightforward plant. Mm. Yeah, we should just be able to plant the last two of that chain of three yellows. Just wants to knock this in. He can take the yellow into the. No, he's covered the pocket. Someone's put some music on. Some beats. Liven up the proceedings here a little. Hopefully the content ID didn't pick it up. I might have to turn the microphone down a little bit now. Oh, it was a wonderful cut by Neil. But he's, I think he was hoping maybe to try and get a little bit of lift off that and come off the yellow and disturb the reds. It's not quite happened. What's he gonna do now? Gone for a safety there. I think Joe needs to try and get this cue ball to fly off this yellow and into the reds and try and knock his yellow in. No, I'm just going to play it gently. He's got a snooker there. Has he got a snooker? It's going to force Neil to recover this red if he can hit it. I'm not sure he can. Yeah. That forces Neil to deal with that bottom red. That was a wonderful shot there by Joe. The problem is, His yellow is still covered by that red. Well, Neil has got some difficult work to do dealing with that red. And if Joe can just get a deflection into it, he can put his yellow down. If he can get the cue ball or the yellow to hit into it. We'll see, I guess. The shore is turning into a drawn out tactical battle. Hopefully one of them is going to find a way through sooner rather than later. What's Joe going to do from here? I think he has to come off a cushion for that yellow. To find a way to skill that yellow in, otherwise he's going nowhere and this frame isn't going anywhere as both these two just dance around. What's Joe going to do here? He's not going to pot it, is he? He's just going to touch it. Yeah. So, Neil, back to the table.
We've got a possible three more frames to come. Our stream sponsor today is Coffee One Shirley. Great coffee, lovely staff. If you're looking to join the staff, they have an assistant manager position available and a part-time barista. So if you know someone who's looking for work, there's a possibility. It's fairly relaxed work, making coffees for people. Get in touch today with Rachel. This is frame 27. Neil Turner to break. Right, he's put a red over the pocket. Joker push a yellow onto that red. Quite easily. Or not. So who is going to be first onto the hill? Neil or Joe? So Neil's on the reds. And he's got one that he needs to develop just below the black. It might go into the middle as it is. On the yellows. Now Neil's covering a pocket. One that Joe needs. A good chance here for Neil. You could snatch this frame quite quickly here and get onto the hill. Yep, he just needs to get on the black now. Left middle. And he's on the hill, 14-13.
versus frame 28. Joe Hamm to break. And it's dry. So we've got an open table here. Neil's just contemplating. I think there's a yellow into the middle. Not an easy shot. You can play it straight up the table for a plant into the top right. He's going to try and cut this red into the bottom left. And he's got it. And all the reds go. And Neil's on the heel here. And he's run out of position. Well, he's covered the pocket quite well there. It's a good touch. Joe's not really been left with a shot on here. But he can try and deflect off this yellow. Or double. And he's got it. He's got to get right down on the bottom left-hand side of the table so he can take out this yellow on the bottom cushion. Those two yellows next to each other need to be separated. Could try and come into those with this shot. He's got to be careful not to push them right over towards the bottom left pocket though, which he's done, because now that's a ball tied up. Well, he went for the skill shot. He's given away a foul. Oh, Neil's attacking straight away. He's not developing anything. He's just going for it. That was a bit of a difficult shot, this one. And he's got it. He's on the black. It'll be down to the bottom right. He could take it into the middle. Bottom right it is. And it's in, and he wins the match 15-13. Congratulations there to Neil Turner, getting over the line in the end. That was a marathon slog there by the two, but they got there. So well done to Neil. Unlucky Joe. Yeah, I've been watching Ad Hoc Money Matches. Get in touch today if you'd like yours streamed. Today's beneficiary was the PDSA, Public Dispensary for Saving Animals, Saving Pets, Changing Lives. If you're looking for a charity to support, why not support them? We have brought you today's action live from Rocket Ronnie's in Southampton, with over 30 tables of various disciplines, dartboards, and live BT Sports on big screen TVs. No memberships required, so just pop on down. They're a fantastic environment. Our next stream is Saturday. Luke Cross versus Rich Chalk, race the 15 for £300. We will definitely see you there, won't we? Today's match sponsor is Appaday Multimedia. That's my company, the company that brings you all of this stuff that you see and hear today. Today's stream sponsor was Coffee One Shirley, and they are hiring. So if you are looking for a new job or know someone who is, then get in touch with them today. Thank you everybody for tuning in. I'm going to get myself home now. I've been sat in this chair for a very long time, so looking forward to getting back. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, and we will catch you next week. Thank you. Bye-bye.